Now we'll look at some more examples of factoring a sum and difference of cubes. We already went over these formulas in the previous video, so let's take a look at our examples. Here we have 4x cubed minus 32. But notice that 4x cubed and 32 are not perfect cubes. But remember, the first step in factoring is to factor out the greatest common factor. These two terms share a common factor of 4. So we'll start by factoring out the 4. This would leave us with 4 times the quantity of x cubed. Then there are 8 4s in 32, so we'll have minus 8. Notice how this binomial factor is a difference of cubes, so now we can factor this further. This is going to factor into a binomial and a trinomial. Before we do this, though, we should recognize that a is going to be equal to x, and b would be equal to 2, since 2 cubed is equal to 8. So now we'll factor this again. We'll still have this extra factor of 4, and then we'll have a binomial factor and a trinomial factor. Notice our binomial factor is going to be a minus b. So in this case, we'd have x minus 2. The first term of the trinomial factor would be a squared, which in this case would be x squared. Then it's going to be plus a times b. Well, if a is x and b is 2, a times b would be x times 2, or 2x, plus b squared. And if b is equal to 2, b squared would be 2 squared, or 4. One more thing to remember here is that this trinomial factor is not going to factor further. So now we've factored this completely. Looking at our second example, we have 2x cubed plus 250. Again, notice in its current form, we do not have a sum of cubes, but we do have a common factor of 2. So we can't forget the first step in factoring is to factor out the greatest common factor. So here, if we factor out the 2, we would have 2 times the quantity x cubed plus 125. And now notice that our binomial factor is a sum of cubes. So now we should recognize that a would be equal to x, and b would be equal to 5, since 5 cubed is equal to 125. So now we can factor this further. We'll have 2 times a binomial times a trinomial. So our binomial is going to be a plus b, or in this case, x plus 5. The first term of the trinomial will be a squared, or in this case, x squared, minus a times b, which would be x times 5, or 5x, plus b squared. And if b is equal to 5, b squared would be 5 squared, or 25. And again, this trinomial is never going to factor, so now we have factored the given polynomial completely. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.